Do I think Yella Beezy could have carried it different? I do, but who are we never, we don't know what we would have done.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gonna talk.
But Mo3, one thing about Mo3, while the beef, everything, Mo3 would never stop communicating with me. Like, the last time I seen Mo3, we were in Houston at this jewelry, TD Jewelers in Houston. I bumped into him. He dropped a video. This was the last time I saw him in his form in Houston. He just dropped a video with Kevin Gates. And the video, it was like out for 2 weeks and it had 14 million views on it. And he was looking at me like so mad, like not mad at me, but like, I want to get to 100 million. Like, I want to be the biggest. Like, Shawn, what do I need to do? How can I get on playlists? Like, for the first, like, he always would ask me questions, but like for the first time, like sitting down like a student trying to figure out how he can make this record with Kevin Gates the biggest in the world. And I'm sitting down talking to him like, bro, you got to do this. You got to do that. Did you get back this? I used to always tell him and Rain, give back, bro. Become the neighborhood hero. Be the guy, like, change the narrative. How you said he was beating up on people, change the narrative. Like, Rain would tell you, I'm the reason why they went out and gave out money to people in the hood. Wow. Yeah, I told him that. Like,
I seen him do that, too.
I just told Yayo the same thing. So if y'all see Yayo giving out, like, I was telling him, bro, you got to create the narrative. The internet is going to create the narrative for you if you don't do it for yourself. You got to create this content of what you want people to see in you. You know what I'm saying?
I agree with that 100%.
So, to my point is, me and Mo3 would never stop talking. He was really a student. Like, he always admitted that he wasn't like really a businessman. Like, you got to understand, he was homeless at the time.
He was.
So he would, if he didn't know, if Rain wouldn't give it to him, he would call me like, hey, bro, so how can I do this? And that was the last time I seen him. So I know I'm rambling right now.
That's how I love.
But Yella, as he got bigger, me and him talked less and less. And he don't owe me shit. Like, I'm not like all these other people, because he just hit me up yesterday. He's giving me a plaque. So that's real.
That's hard.
And I even in on the show, I said, give one a Half Pint, because I felt like Half Pint.
That's real.
Like, come on, bro. Between me, Half Pint, him, like, that shit made it go crazy. Mm-hmm. But as he got bigger, me and Yella stopped talking. And he was getting booked shows, features, getting flew out everywhere. But he never owed me nothing. But we didn't fall out, though. It was just, as he got bigger, I don't know if it was because me and Mo3 relationship or him blowing up. I don't know. I never questioned him. I never cared.
Did you basically understood that he was getting bigger, too?
Yeah. Like, that's, bro, you don't owe me shit.
That's the one
when
thing.
When that shit went gold and platinum, I never said, hey, bro. I never shot no slugs at him. Never
that
did,
ain't you, though.
Never did none of that. Like, it is what it is, bro. I'm a man. I got this shit on my own. I'm going to continue doing this shit. If we bump heads, if we become cool again, fine. Like, if you hit me up and you want to post, fine. I've never charged none of these guys in the city that came up with me. Never charged Yayo. Never charged Sauce Walker. Never charged Mo3. Never charged any of these guys that, like, helped me. I never wanted nothing for them. But if I have something that I need from y'all, like, y'all got this artist that need a feature, like, can we swap out?
That's right.
Like, because I'm trying to build. Like, that's how I am. I'm trying to build. I'm not trying to compete. I don't got to be the richest one either. Yeah. I just want to be comfortable. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So
that's big that Yella try to get, you know, the plaques and do the things that it take to, you know, really, really show that he did appreciate everybody. Mm-hmm. I think he did. I think he just grew, you know. I think
it was a lot of pressure, too.
Well, you got to think about it. Like, even, say, Taylor, the one I always talk about, Taylor Gabriel, that's my little homie, been coming here since he was, like, him and Mr. Hit That was here before anybody. I've been knowing him since they was, 16, 17, 15, and he went off and became, you know, he worked millions, 30 NFL plus thing. Millions in the NFL, and right. He came back, but I never, when I would call him, you can go to the interview when I interviewed him, I never bothered him like that.
Yeah, I was
just like, you know, if it happened, it happened. But if it don't, it don't. Yeah. I still love you, but I understand. You got a mission you got to do.
That's the difference, E. That's the difference, like, because when you got two friends who's grinding towards their goals and what they trying to do, they don't get caught up in the bullshit. I'm sorry. They don't get caught up in the bullshit in the sense of, man, he ain't pick up the phone.
Yeah.
Or, man, he Hollywood. Or, man, he's changed.
Yeah.
Because, dog, I'm grinding, dog. Yeah, like, I already know. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, I see you calling, but shit, let me get this last set.
Yeah.
And this last set done turned into an hour. And then from that hour, I went into my entrepreneurship, and that turned into another hour. So at the end of the day, man, I'm tired. You know what I'm saying? And I forgot to hit you back, but that doesn't mean I don't love you.
Exactly.
So also, that means you're not working as hard as me.
That's
you know
right.
what I'm saying? If you waiting
you
on
have
me.
Too much yeah. time
you
on
got
your
too
hands.
Much time on your hands, dog. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, and that's what I've already respected about you, he has always kept it so, you know what I mean, 100.
Work.
Man, because he grinded. He was his own boss. You know what I'm saying? Bosses relate to other bosses. Right. You know what I'm saying? And we supposed to be in a room with each other and sit at the dinner table together and eat with each other. You know what I'm saying? And create other bosses. So exactly. I can't.
Thank you. And I'm going to keep it up because I understand that he's growing, that he's getting bigger and bigger. And I got to respect the same thing with you. If people don't hear the call, they should be happy for you. And I know you'll get back to me when he can. Right. But don't ever take it personal, because it ain't like you changed like that mentally inside. Mm-hmm. You still feel the same about the people that you pretty much originally, you know, was cool with.
Yep.
And I think Jay said it best. He say, the money don't change you.
Everybody else
he said everybody around you change. Mm-hmm. So I agree with that. Yeah. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I agree with that too. And back to the Yella Beezy thing too. Nobody knows how it feels to be the only rapper in the city that's hot at a time. And is it so much pressure? You got your day one friends expecting shit from you. You got girls, your mom, friends trying to rob you. Niggas want to kill you. That shit drives you insane, bro. Like, so all these people have things to say about Yella and Mo3 or whoever else that they feel like owes them. They never know how it feels to be at the top and a million people want something from you, wishing on your downfall. So, do I think Yella Beezy could have carried it different? I do, but who are we never we don't know what we would have done. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
we really don't know. Like it, man. I don't know. You know what I'm saying?
I wonder, and this is something I'll ask Rain whenever he is on the show again. Whenever he comes back, like, could these two guys say, we know we not going to ever rock with each other?
Man, I tried to sit them down.
No. I know we ain't going to ever rock with each other, but we need to, you know, just pretty much say we don't rock with each other, but we cool. People need to move on with their life. Yeah. Just be able to just say that.
Because Rain called me and said he wanted to sit down with him on the podcast. and to be, and this is, damn, I hope he not mad at me, but Yella was kind of like that. Like, if it was done right, like, Not no hood nigga shit and entourages, but like real sit down, like
he would do it.
Yeah, he said he would do it. This was his last week.
They both. I mean,
are you gonna set it up?
Yeah, but I'm trying to see like how could I do it to where it's like maybe we have like enforcement and you know not no entourages, but like a real maybe like because I don't want this shit to be just some nigga shit about music, but like kids are watching us. I want this to be about the community.
Come on now.
You know, healing. Not no fucking just for views.
Come
and
on now.
I want this shit to be to where as though like the kids, you know, we could do something for the, you know, like.
Yeah, yeah.
So.
I hope it happens, man. Like I said, that would be big for the city. Mm-hmm. Just to, huge. Like I said, even if they said we're not going, we'll never be friends like that. But we can agree that, hey man, you know, everybody, we in the city, we want the best for Dallas. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gon' talk.